हेलो हाय, दिस इज़ रवि जैन एंड आई एम हियर टू टीच यू द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट ऑफ द थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो अबाउट द व्हाट इज़ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। देन द थर्मोडायनेमिक्स इज द ब्रांच ऑफ द साइंस इन विच वी डील्स विद द एनर्जी ट्रांसफर एंड इट्स इफेक्ट्स ऑन द प्रॉपर्टीज फिजिकल एज वेल एज केमिकल ऑन द सब्सटेंस। Basically, what we will do in the thermodynamics, we discuss and we study about the energy as well as work transfer from the one system to the another system. Basically, the amount of heat transfer taking place while arriving on one state from another is the main concern in the thermodynamics. Now, the term comes in our mind, the system and surrounding. The first term is system. What is system? System basically we can say the fixed quantity or we can say the fixed mass which we choose in the universe for our study of the thermodynamics. Now we can say that it is nothing but the fixed mass or region in space where our study is focused. Now then what is surrounding? Everything external to the system is known as surrounding. And the system and surrounding both known as universe. Now, what is system? There are three types of system in our thermodynamics. The first one is closed system, second is open system, and third one is an isolated system. Now, the first one is a closed system. What is closed system? We can say if there is no mass as well as energy transfer in any system is called as a closed system, like piston cylinder arrangement without valve. If we having an arrangement of piston cylinder arrangement but there is no valve, it means there is no mass as well as energy transfer. It means there is no mass flow rate as well as no energy input and output. Now second is open system. What is the open system? It is the type of system in which both energy as well as mass interaction takes place. Example, if there is a piston cylinder arrangement but with valves, like IC engine, there is inlet valve as well as outlet valves, exhaust valve. Now third one is an isolated system. It is a type of system in which neither energy nor mass interaction takes place, like our thermoflask, which we are using in daily routine in our home. Okay, now boundary. What is boundary? Boundary, it is nothing but a you can say it is a region from where energy transfer, energy and work transfer takes place. It is real or imaginary surface that separates from the surrounding. If system and surrounding separates by a imaginary or a real wall is called as a boundary. It can be fixed as well as movable. You can see in the diagram there is a piston cylinder arrangement and there is a piston, the top surface of the piston is movable, but all the three sides is fixed. Like see the compressor, the another picture here, it is a compressor. Like see, this is compressor is a open system. Then the both up and down is the real boundary, and see the dotted line is a imaginary boundary from where mass flow rate comes and out. Now see the properties of the system. What are the properties of the system? Any characteristics of the system is known as the property of the system. Basically there are two types of properties. The first one is the intensive properties and second one is the extensive properties. What is intensive and what is extensive? The first one is the intensive. Intensive properties are those properties which are independent of the mass, like density, temperature, pressure, which did not depend upon the mass. And the second is the extensive properties. And what is extensive properties? Those properties which dependent on the mass, like volume, enthalpy, entropy, kinetic energy, potential energy. These are the extensive properties. See the example. Here I am separating the mass, volume, temperature, pressure, and density. See, if we divide in half, see, mass will be half, volume will be half, but temperature, pressure, and density will remain constant. It means temperature, pressure, and density does not depend upon the mass. That's why this is the extensive properties. Okay, now see, all the specific properties are the intensive properties, like specific volume, specific enthalpy, specific entropy. Because if we divide it, any properties is divided by mass, it will be independent and it will become the intensive property. It means we can say extensive properties per unit mass is called intensive properties. Like there are key points with respect to properties. The first key points are the point function, and the second are exact differential, and third one are independent of the past history. Now there are three important terms comes: the state, process, and process path. Then what is state? Any condition of the system is known as the state. And any condition, if we draw a PV diagram, see, if you draw any PV diagram in, and what we see that we required at least two properties to define any state. Okay, like suppose if you drawing a compression process, it means what happened? Pressure will increase and volume will decrease. It means we required at least two thermodynamic properties to describe any state, P1 V1, P2 V2. Now, and what is process? Change of state is called process. If you are changing the state from 1 to 2, is called process. And what is the process path? The infinite state through which the system passes while going from initial state to the final state. If you are going from the initial state to the final state, and which path we are following is called process path. Now the very important term, the quasi-static process. And what is the quasi-static process? It is the kind of the process that occurs infinitely slow, because this is a reversible process, and it always denoted by the joint lines. And suppose you having you having a container, and you putting the mass, the infinite mass on the container, and you are removing slowly one by one one unit of mass. Then what will happen? The piston will goes up, and the volume of the container will increase. This is there is an n number of equilibrium state during initial state to the final state. This is the quasi-static process. There are n number of equilibrium state. This is called as a quasi-static process. And what is the non-quasi-static process? Does not occurs infinitely slow. It represents by the dashed line. Now, a very important term: reversible and the irreversible process. Now, what is reversible? It is a kind of the process which can be reversible in the direction following the same path without leaving any effect on the system and the surrounding. If you are going from the initial state to the final state, and if you want to come back from the final state to the initial state, but if you are leaving, and if you are leaving no effect on the system and the surrounding, it is called as a reversible process. And what is reversible process? What is irreversible process? It is a kind of process which is not reversible. Basically, we can say the all quasi-static process are not reversible, but reversible process is always quasi-static, because we already studied about the quasi-static. Quasi-static is an infinitely slow process, and if there is an infinitely slow process, process is called as a reversible process. Now, basically, for the study of the thermodynamics, we have two analyses, microscopic analysis and macroscopic analysis. And what is macroscopic analysis? In this analysis, average molecule behavior is taken into consideration. This approach is valid till the concept of the continuum holds good. If you know about the kinetic theory of the gases, we always see the average molecular behavior for the study of the thermodynamics. But in the case of microscopic analysis, we always take the mean free path of the each and every molecule for our study. Now, pressure, what is pressure? First of all, we should know about the what is pressure. Pressure is nothing but the normal component of the force per unit area. It's called pressure. Pressure in gas is due to force occurring because of colliding molecules with the surface, and it acts normal to the surface. What is pressure? If there are so many molecules of the gas which collides each other on the surface, is called pressure. Pressure is nothing but the function of density and the temperature. Density is directly proportional to the number of the molecules colliding. And what is liquid? In liquid, pressure in the liquid is due to the repulsion of the molecules. Now, the very important term, the thermodynamic equilibrium. What is thermodynamic equilibrium? There are, if any system in equilibrium with thermal, mechanical, chemical and phase, in charo equilibrium mein hai, to wo kis mein kehlayega? Thermodynamic equilibrium. Now, what is thermodynamic equilibrium? If there is equality of temperature, what is mechanical equilibrium? There is no unbalanced force. What is chemical equilibrium? There is no chemical composition which change with the time, is called chemical equilibrium. And what is phase equilibrium? The mass of each phase should remain constant with time. It's called phase equilibrium. If any system is in all these equilibrium, is called a thermodynamic equilibrium. Thank you so much, guys. This is the basic introduction part of the thermodynamics. Tomorrow we will start the second lecture of the thermodynamics, the zeroth law and the thermometry. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.